It is the first time this tree will be wired and styled, so it will just be an initial styling. It will need several adjustments over the years to come. It is a yamadori pine, a Scots pine from Sweden, Pinus sylvestris. It has quite flexible branches, but this part of the trunk is a heavier one and thicker one, and it needs some power to force it into position. This will involve some raffia that I will wrap around the trunk and the branches that need a heavier bending to protect them from breaking. The inner tissue that lies just underneath the bark, the water transporting tissue, the raffia will help tighten up this part. The raffia needs to go into some water to be a little bit more elastic. When it has sucked up water for 15 minutes to 30 minutes, it will be ready to use. When applied to a tree, and it has to be applied strongly and sit very tight, when it dries up slowly, it will tighten a little bit more. But the most important thing is to use your power to really set it tight so it has, so it does its job. We need some different wires, and this will be a little bit more advanced than the normal wiring, because I need to apply wires along the trunk as well as around the trunk. This tree is now ready for the first styling. It has been growing very healthy for 2.5 years since it was collected. This is shown by a new strong growth, and I let go at least 2 seasons with this strong growth before I begin the first initial styling. The first styling is always a little bit rough, like a sketch, and then you build on within the years to come. This is a very raw material, yamadori material, and I have to take care not to go forward too fast, because I will lose the time in the future if I'm doing it too hasty, because I will reduce the health and the speed of growing with this tree if I do so. Pines are difficult trees, so you should not do them as a beginner, but wait until you have some experience with trees that cope more when you are pruning and wiring them. I always take my time studying the tree before I begin the styling, because it is very important to be sure what you want to do before you apply the first wire. The challenge of this tree is the first part, where the main branch here goes out from a trunk in a little bit awkward position, but I'll try to use this as a key feature in the new design. Let's start putting some wet raffia on. It is important to use some force. You have to use some power to really set it tight and really close, so there is no gap between the strings of raffia. And then you just continue this until you have protected all of the trunk. And when it is not long enough, you just bind it together with a new piece and continue. You can cut off some of these extensions where you have joined the 2 pieces of raffia. It is important to continue all the way up to where you expect to make some heavy bending, and it is better to apply a little bit too much so you protect the tree as much as possible. And finally, just finishing it off by making a little knot so it doesn't run off when I begin to apply the wire, and anything loose you can just cut off to clean it up and make it nice and tidy. I will put a piece of wire at the outside of this, alongside it, and then a 45 degrees wire at the other part, so it will stick together and make it much stronger than if I'm just wiring normally. I fix it with a thin piece of wire to keep it in position. And the same thing here, so it stays in place. Just until the other wire comes around. And I will add another piece to this, because there's so much strength in this part, so I need something heavier to hold it in position when it is bent. And the same procedure, small wires to attach it. Now I can begin apply the next wire that goes around these two supporting wires. Applying it in a 45 degrees angle and sitting it tight without breaking anything. This second wire has to follow the first one very closely, because this will give it the extra strength needed to hold it in place when I begin to bend it. As closely as possible. This was the first step, double wiring alongside the trunk and around the trunk. Now we should be able to bend it, but before we start this I have to wire the other branches too. Here I can use a thinner wire, and I don't need the raffia to protect them because they are younger and will not be bent as heavily as the other ones. Before wiring the small branches, it is necessary to clean them up for the needles around here that will be squeezed by the wire. So you have a clean spot to apply the wire on. It's important that you drag them in the growing direction and not the other way around. Earlier in autumn, you will have a chance for these to grow new branches from these small points where there is a sleeping bud, but at this time it's just about cleaning up, so I have a good piece at the end with 8 to 10 pair of needles, and then these can be arranged when they are wired. There's different kinds of solutions to a bonsai like this when you decide how to style it. It can go in different directions, and it is sometimes there's only one choice, but here I see several choices. So try to find the best movement in the tree and bring forward the characteristics of it. And you can do that by tilting the tree, and you will already get some movement in here. So it's about bringing out the most dramatic and most interesting features of the tree. Do this bending little by little. It's actually not the branch itself that makes resistance, it's the wire that is tough to bend. Sometimes you wire a branch because you don't know if you're going to need it, but this one has to go. I started keeping it because I expected it to be used. But it will just be in the way, so it goes off, and I take it out here, and I can maybe use it as a gin later, but for now it's going to be these branches I will build upon. Now I concentrate on arranging the top of the tree to get it in balance. You have to have the middle part of the top of the tree approximately at the same line as the trunk is. And this all depends on how long branches you have to make a balance or not. So you adjust these branches and the balance of the tree but simply by judging how it looks, and do not follow any guidelines or rules. You have to use your artistic sense to evaluate how it works. I have chosen that the movement of the tree and the flow goes to this side, so I keep the longest branch here. It needs to develop foliage pads closer to the trunk too, but I will keep a longer branch here and shorter one here to get a flow in this direction. I also find it important that when you style a tree, if you have some movement in the trunk, this should continue all through the branches out to the tips. Some trees have more possibilities, but I simply wanted to go with the flow here because I have a long branch here, and I like the way it starts the movement here and continues here. It should be like a Japanese ink painting. If you have some very soft lines, you continue these soft lines all the way through. If you have a formal tree with a straight trunk, also the branches also have to have the same flow. Then you need to form the branches straight too, so they have the same flow and same energy. And this is just to make it harmoniously and peaceful. If you have a soft trunk with a lot of curves and you have very stiff branches, this will simply be a contradiction and look unnatural. It feels more natural to go with the first movement and continue this. Thank you. It is about 2 months since I did the last work on this Pinus sylvestris, a Scots pine collected in the wild in Sweden. It is time to take the second step, and the reason why I have waited 2 months from the first initial styling of the trunk and main branches is that the tree needed some rest after this pretty heavy bending of the main branch, and this is now becoming the trunk. The reason I did the first initial styling in autumn was because the tree still has some root growth. Therefore, it will be able to cope with the heavy bending of the main branch, now a part of the trunk. And I let the finer branches stay for 2 months, so the tree was able to recover from the first initial part of the styling. If you do everything at once, you risk the tree to die back for some points and you will stress it unnecessarily. I do not have to force anything because I'm not doing a demonstration here. I'm doing this work on this tree and I want it to succeed. Therefore, I take my time. I don't lose any time doing this. In contradiction, I will gain some time because if I did it too hasty and had the branches dying back, I had to start over. So instead, I have taken my time, let it rest for 2 months, and now I will finish off the final styling of the outer branches. In order not to stress a bonsai too much, it is important to give it a rest between some of the operations. You might do this on a demonstration on a stage where you do everything at once, but you risk the life of the tree. It is a pretty rough treatment to bend a thick branch like this and bend it in position and curve it around like this. You will stretch the tissue and the inner cells and you will break it at points, and it needs to heal up. What I will concentrate on today is to refine the lower part of the tree first. It is easier to place the lower branches first because if you start at the top and have branches coming down here, I can't get my hands in and control the next part. So always work from below and up. I think design-wise, the most important part of this tree will be this branch. Of course, it was important to make use of the former trunk that was growing up here, thickening this part. It was removed early on, and instead of trying to use it because it was a very odd branch, and it has the function that it thickened the lowest part of the trunk. The only way you can thicken a trunk is to let something grow, a branch grow wildly, and then cut it off later. We call it a sacrifice branch when we do it on purpose. This was from the nature. It has been growing and I removed it. And I had this little odd angle on the tree, and I had to find a way to make use of this. So instead of having a tree with a straight trunk going up, I had decided to follow the movement that starts from this base, because it goes up like this and then it turns over here. So I just want to continue this movement all around in the tree and out in the branches. So the first step has been taken, and now I will begin wiring the finer branches and begin to set them in position. This will be an initial styling. It will not be the finished work because it will take years to come, where I will reduce some parts and I will expand some parts, and let's see how the tree develops. It's not necessary to make a finished tree at once. You have years to do that, and this is just the start in the life of this tree as a bonsai. Glasses on, work to be done. A small thing to take notice of is that when you are wiring finer branches, sometimes it can be difficult to attach the wire to another branch or to the trunk. So I have put this in between some of the thick wires and just let it grab in here so it can stick instead of trying to cross the wire. Another detail to take notice of is when you want a branch bent downwards and you want it to hold, then place the wire on top of the branch in the start of the bend. This will help press it down. If you want a branch to go upwards, you take the wire and apply it from beneath and close to the main trunk or main branch, then it will stay in position better. And when I apply the wire, I support it underneath with my fingers so I can hold it all the way around so it doesn't get loose. It has to sit tight. Not too tight, but how can you express it? Gently but tight. And the snip goes off. And I can bend it in position. The tip of this branch have to point a little bit upwards, because if it grows points down, it will weaken the growth. It has to point a little bit upwards to reach the light, and it will strengthen the branch and grow better. Here's a small weak branch. I will not wire this because it's too fragile. I will risk the life of it. So instead I apply wire to this branch that is a little thicker, and it can go around here. It has to start close. I support it with my fingers underneath. Follow it all the way so I don't break this thin branch. Pines can be a little fragile when you bend them. They are very flexible, but you have to take care not to overdo it. And the tip will point a little upwards. I can take a little of this growth off. It's a little bit too much. Not necessarily. It has to be equal to the other tip, so the growth is equally supported all the way out of the end. And I have two pieces of growth out here. I have a new shoot here and another small one here, so I will take care not to damage these. They point upwards and get the growing direction they want, so they can be strong growing in the future. If I don't take these old needles off here and I begin to wire it, they will be sitting back and decay, and this might be a place for some fungal attacks, because dead plant material is what fungus like, so we have to keep that away from the tree. Maybe this will be it. This branch may be a little bit too long for the future, but I want as much foliage stay on the tree as possible, because the more photosynthesis this tree can make, and the better it will grow in future. So it's better to keep too much foliage on and then remove what is extensive later on when the tree is in a good growing condition and in a good health. Pines are absolutely one of my favorite specimens to work on, because they are flexible, they are elegant, and they are unfortunately difficult to maintain, because they need a very well-draining soil. They don't like their feet wet when they are managing the conditions in the mountain areas of Sweden and Norway. This tree is from Sweden, as I told you. They are coping with very dry climate and only very little soil. Here we are at a point where there are too many branches emerging from the same point, so we will have a problem later on if we don't clean out this, because this will thicken up in a circle around here and will just make a clump that will look very odd and unnatural. So here are way too many branches, so I take off the upper one and I let this piece stay so it can dry back by itself, instead of cutting it too close and I risk some dieback here. So I let this sit and I can remove it after some time. I take the middle one below the same way, so I have like a two pieces separating here, and they can make a nice zigzag pattern if we continue the work all the way through. And I have avoided this part to thicken more. It is a little bit thicker than at the part here, but it will look fine in future. And then I can apply some wire here, and I cannot do it like this because I have the problem that it will be a little unstable, so I have to attach it to a branch further back, and it can be this one at the back, and I will just follow the wire that is already placed here. Here we have this problem with wire that crosses, but if it is firmly in contact, I will support it with my finger here on top of the branch, because I want to make it more stable when I bend it down. This will work, and I will follow the original wire placed earlier, 2 months ago, with this wire. It has to go close so it looks nice and holds better. And it will go all the way out on this branch. I can go underneath here, it's a free space. Now it becomes too much with all of this on the roll. And I will go on top, supported with my fingers all the way, and take very much care because here is a new butt. So I have to take care not to damage this, because it can be new growth for the future. And now the wire becomes a little bit too thick. So we take a thinner one and continue. Gives this a little more strength with a double wire. And off with the rest. Yeah, I have a very thin branch inside. Maybe it should be cut off, but it can also be part of this. So for the moment, I will let it stay, wire it lightly, and then later it can be removed if it shows to be too much. Yeah, I apply a thin wire, but double at the same time, because I didn't have the exact right thickness of wire to do this. So I just put a thinner wire and doubled it. And then I can split it at the end, one to this branch and one to this, and clean it out. And this tip is a little weaker, so I will leave more folded back, more needles back to support the growth. And I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear in the background I have company. There is a woodpecker somewhere behind me that is working on a tree too, so nice to have company and work on trees together. As you can see, we are getting closer to an end. I have moved the tree indoor because it's simply too cold for my fingers to work outside at this time. We are near to the freezing point. I have wired most of the tree, just finishing the last part here, and I can begin the final styling of the tree. We are in the middle of January, and it is a perfect time to wire any kind of bonsai, actually. This is the last branch to be wired, and then we are ready to make the first initial styling of this Scots pine. Why we're doing this wiring in winter is because the sap flow is low, and you will hurt the tree much less than if you did it at summer, when the growth is at its high point. You should always start placing the lowest branch first, because then you can work your way up to the tree. If you start at the top, you will have problems with branches being in the way when you are placing the branch. When I arrange the branches here, I try to make a little bit of a spread, making a fan evenly distributed. It is not just about arranging the branches so it looks good, it is also important to have in mind how the tree grows, that all the foliage get the light it needs, so photosynthesis will work and the tree will be in good health and in a good growing condition. So think about design and the growth of the tree at the same time is important. The tips are pointing upwards, so they will grow well, except this one, that will need a little support here. This might be adjusted several times over the years to come, depending how it grows. This branch may be a bit too much, so it will have to go. This I will let stay, because the wire is attached to this one and it will lose its grip around here if I take this off. It can just be removed later on. Now we can go to the next step. This is the most important branch because it makes all the flow of the tree, all the movement starting from here and going around up to the top and continued here. In the future maybe it has to be a little shorter, but I will wait and take that decision at that time. The next level to place is this one that has to go down here to cover some of this bend here, because it is a little like too uniform in bend, but maybe it should be dragged further down, but I think it's good for now, so I'll just let this branch drop down here as the next level and make an interesting movement, continuing the flow from the left to the right. Everything has to be done gently and not bending more than one time in one direction, because else you ruin the tissue underneath and the branch risk some dieback. Is a great thing about bonsai is, and it may sound a little bit silly, it is about waiting, see how the development of what I have done, how it will succeed or not in the future, making correction and waiting for the tree to mature and become a bonsai. Right now it's not really a bonsai, it's a tree in training to be a bonsai. And now I have to take a decision, should I cover some more of this? I think I will do a little, I want to see the trunk between the branches, but I also want to have some of this going down here to make some interest to the tree. It can be removed later if it is too much, but for now I think it will be really a great, an interesting view inside here. You can still see the trunk here and here, just have to keep some openings. And I also want some of the tips going in this direction, so I make a little bit of the movement back in and I make a midpoint here where everything is pointing together, instead of having all the tips going that direction here and in that direction here, then you make some kind of a negative direction in the tree instead of bringing it together. And then we have the left side here, and I have forgotten some wiring here. Just finish that off. This is a low branch, the most important branch that brings all the energy and flow over to this part of the tree. Now we have to place a branch on the opposite side of the tree that is not at the same level as this one. You have to have an uneven length. You have to avoid branches being at exactly the same level. I bring this down too because I want to make this image of a tree growing in Sweden, where this is from, that has the branches forced down by heavy snowfalls in winter. This is natural for this tree to grow in these conditions, and I'm trying to reflect this in the branches that are dropping down. Here's another one I haven't wired. Maybe I should, but it's a little bit thin, so I'll leave it for now. So you have to think about the history of the tree when you are designing it. At the same time, you have to think about the health of the tree, taking care not to wire branches that might die back just because you're overdoing the work. And here we have a good space between these two branches. We can still see the trunk. I want these tips to point, have a little bit of direction here, so we join the tree like this instead of just pulling it away from each other. We need, this was a branch I was talking about earlier. I thought I would cut it off at first, but now I can see it is an important branch to add some depth in here, so we just have something of interest in the back to make it three-dimensional instead of being a flat piece of work. It's very important that you can have empty spaces, negative spaces, that brings interest to the tree, and like a watercolor painting, you will fill out the rest of the image in your mind, and you just have to keep that open. And I always say, keep open spaces, like if a bird could fly in and sit on a branch. So this was the placement of this important branch too, and I need to have something here at the back so we can have this depth. And this is some branches that needs development over the years so they can fill in more, but that will come with time. Now we are coming closer to arranging the top of the tree. That should be idealistic in the center part of the trunk, but this is mostly a matter of how well the balance is in the tree. So it's not necessarily have to be at that point, but it's a good guideline. Remember, there are no rules in bonsai, but there are guidelines to help you designing and deciding how you make things work. And sometimes breaking these so-called rules, preferably called guidelines, will add more interest to the work. So here we go with the top, the canopy of the tree, without getting too much in conflict with other branches, trying to make an evenly distributed branch structure so light can reach all branches and we have a peaceful image. Well, definitely this is in the way. I can't let it be. Just off with it. Now back to the canopy. Sometimes you design or you see bonsai that are designed with a very heavy top part of the bonsai. I think it's sometimes a bit too much. I like it when it is more evenly distributed, so you have a better balance and not this top heavy crown or canopy. I think this tree should stay with a light image, and that means that the branches should, the foliage pad should be a little bit smaller in, and not too dense, because the main trunk is not very dense. It's a little bit light. It's not a big, huge, heavy clump that needs a heavy foliage to compete with it or to harmonize with it. So these foliage pads will in future be kept a little bit lighter by cutting out some of the growth in between when it has matured over the years, so it have this harmoniously looking design. It's important to think about these things, but it's early stages, and a lot of things can happen over the years. New decisions, you see a new branch development, something of interest that you want to enhance, and the tree might change a little over time. I have to bring this in closer here. This was the first initial styling of this Swedish Scots pine. You can watch much more at bonsaivideo.com.